What is up, guys? Ben here with Half Man Half Tech. So last week, Apple released iOS 13.5.1 to the public and to all supported devices. So if you had a supported device, and that is from the iPhone 6S, which is the lowest supported device of iOS 13.5, you could be able to download this software from the air. Now, I did install it on my iPhone 6S here, and this is a follow-up video after using iOS 13.5.1 for 6 days. So a lot has changed and a lot has happened in terms of performance and battery and bugs. So if you're new to this particular channel, make sure you hit subscribe down below so that you don't miss any of the latest content that we have coming your way. Now, when it comes to performance, I'm quite happy with what I'm getting on this device. Performance wise, I can tell that there's a plus when it comes to iOS 13.5.1 on the iPhone 6S. If you look at the camera app, the way it opens, it's so fast, way faster than before. All apps are opening as they are supposed to, and there's no jump or delay when opening apps like the settings. And if you close everything, you know, and reopen the apps, you can see that it's very fast, and I'm happy when it comes to performance wise GPU and CPU performance. So it's a plus when it comes to the iPhone 6S running iOS 13.5 performance wise. However, when it comes to the battery performance, if you go into the settings and then go to the battery section and then go to the battery health there, you can see that I have 82% as my maximum battery health capacity. Now, last week when I updated to this iOS 13.5, I actually had 84%. So in a matter of 6 days, 6 days only, I managed to lose 2% of my maximum capacity, and that's with no heavy usage. This phone is rarely used, and I don't know why that happened. It could be a bug that came with iOS 13.5.1. However, we'll see when the next update comes, and when I update, and I will be able to tell you if my battery health or maximum capacity improved. So in terms of battery performance, it's very low, and as you can see, the screen on time that I have been getting for the last 10 days, let's say for example yesterday, you can see that I had 11 hours and 34 minutes screen on time with 1 hour and 10 minutes screen off time. If you combine that, you can see that it's slightly over 13 hours, and looking at the percentage usage that's associated with those 13 hours, you can see that it's over 220%. So that is charging this device more than 2 times and getting about 13 hours of screen on time. So battery wise and battery performance, I'm quite disappointed with the usage and the performance that I'm getting here. As you can see, it's on the low end. However, you also need to keep in mind that my battery health maximum capacity is on 2%. Now for the iPhone, it's actually supposed to be changed at a certain number of charge cycles. So your battery that's inside this iPhone has a certain cap of charge cycles that it's supposed to work normal, and usually it's around 80%. So at around 80%, this battery will need servicing. And also, if you want to check your battery cycle count, I'll leave a link to that video around here. And for the iPhone, I think it's capped at 500. So at around 500 charge cycles, you are expected to service or replace your iPhone battery. So keep in mind that I have 82%, so maybe that's why I'm getting very low and very bad battery performance. Also, if you look at my percentage there, I have 42%, and from the moment I actually started recording this video, I think I had about 49 or 48%, so I've lost about 6% in a matter of 5 minutes. Also, keep in mind that the iPhone 6s has a 1715 milliamp hour battery, so it's quite a small battery in this iPhone. And when I'm charging this device, I noticed that I'm just using this standard iPhone head charger, and this is a 5-volt 1-amp charger, and it charges super fast. I don't know if it's probably the condition of the battery that's decaying, but yeah, that's it when it comes to battery performance. Now let's look at some issues that most of you have been reporting on YouTube. So if we open my initial video on the iPhone 6s, let's
5 minutes later.
Network was a bit slow right there, as you saw. And if we look at my video of the iPhone 6S that I posted about 6 days ago, so if we open the video and go to the comment section, we can see that, yeah, Hiver there says, 13.4 and I want to update, but I'm scared. Should I do it? So when it comes to iOS 13.5.1, it's quite stable in a way. However, when it comes to battery performance, you can see that it's a bit on the low end. So if you have perhaps a better battery percentage, or your maximum battery health capacity is around 90 or above, then I don't think you should actually have a problem when it comes to 13.5.1. However, anything below that, when it comes to battery performance, you are surely going to be hit. And so I will leave it up to your discretion. And then also going down here, you can see that Lucas says, did you maybe encounter with power and home buttons sometimes not working at all? Started with me with 13.4.1. So when it comes to this iOS 13.5.1, I actually haven't experienced any hardware issues when it comes to the home button or the power button right here, and also either the combination of both buttons. If you can see here, you can see that I can take a screenshot right there. And so my volume up and volume down button is also working fine, as you can see. So when it comes to hardware, I actually haven't experienced any issue when it comes to iOS 13.5.1. So that's about it when it comes to iOS 13.5.1. As you can see, a lot has been going on, and hopefully this helps you in making a decision whether to update or not. And before we end this video, a quick shout out to our sponsor. This video was sponsored by Intego Mac Protection. Now, Intego is a Mac-based system that is designed to help protect your Mac against adware, malware, and spyware. So if you're worried about those three things and also want to improve the performance of your MacBook, check out Intego, and I'll leave a link in the description of this video where you can get 50% off of your purchase. And thank you very much for watching and reaching this far into this video. If you watch the whole video, thank you very much for doing that, and you guys are the best. So when the next software comes out, which is probably iOS 13.5.2 or something else, as Apple has been renaming their updates randomly, so when that comes out, I'll surely update this iPhone 6s, and I'll also let you know what are the issues and bugs that I'm experiencing. Thank you very much once again. If you like this video, please leave a like and subscribe down below. Stay safe, and I will definitely see you in the next upload. Peace.